This video, we're going to build an image generation app using OpenAI's brand new image generation API. We're going to build a cartoon image generator to take a photo and turn it into four different versions of that photo in a cartoon format. I can't wait to show you what goes into building this and how easy it is to actually build an app like this. After you watch the video, let me know in the comments if you think I should monetize this and turn it into a real app that others can use, or if you want to use it yourself, leave a comment below. Before we get into that, this video is brought to you by No Code MBA. If you want to learn how to build with no code and AI tools yourself, across no code tools like Bubble, Webflow, Airtable, Glide, Zapier, and a lot more, click the link in the description. We're currently giving $50 off to the first 25 people who claim the discount in the description. Also, if you want to build an AI app, but you don't want to spend the time creating it yourself or learning how to do it, click the link in the description and I'll match you with a top AI expert who can build your app for you. Let's get into it. OpenAI just released their new image generation API, and in this video, we're going to build a real app using it. So if we go to the OpenAI Playground, you can go to images on the left side. You do have to verify your organization, which basically just means verifying that you're a real person. They have a process to do that, which just takes a couple minutes. And then once you have access to the images playground, you can use this. This is the same high quality image generation functionality that is in ChatGPT right now. But you have a few different options. You can change the quality between high, medium, and low. Quality, what I found, it's like the actual quality of the image. So not just the resolution, but like how well it follows the prompt and how good of a job it does. And you can change the size as well. You can also change the number of images to get at once. So you can get up to 10 images at once out of this API. You can upload images as well. And then they also in the playground have some inspiration, which is actually really nice. So like, let's say the inspiration is a concert ticket. It basically will upload an image and then it gives you a prompt example, which is really helpful when you're building apps to kind of look through all of these prompt examples, because OpenAI thought a lot about these. And if they're including these as a prompt example, it's probably going to be useful for you. So what I want to do is first, I like to build a PRD, a product requirements document, using Grok. So I'm going to show you how I did that. So here we are in Grok. I just said write a PRD for me. And the app that we're going to build is basically like an app that converts images of people into cartoon versions of themselves. So kind of a fun little app here. And I described what I wanted to do, how I wanted it to use the camera. And then I also want to give it the API docs directly from OpenAI. So I'm going to show you how to get that. So if we're back at the playground, and I'm going to go to the history and just like click into one of these that I made already. You can also just generate a new one. Then if you click on the bottom left and we open it up, here we're able to, first of all, we can see the prompt. This is one of the example prompts that OpenAI provided. Quality, size, etc. Input, output. One thing to note, so it costs about, it varies a bit depending on like the size, but in general, low quality is about 1 cent an image, medium is about 4 cents an image, and high is about, I think, 15, 17 cents an image, 16 cents an image, something like that. So if I click view code, what's great about this is now I can see the exact API call that is required here. So I'm just going to copy that, and then I'll paste that in. And I'm going to say this is an example API call. And then I'm going to go down as well. Go back and use this example real quick. If you open it up, the reason I want to do it is this was where I was testing like having a person and putting a shirt on that person, like a virtual try on. The reason I want to use this as an example is because we have an image being passed through, which is something we're going to be doing in our app as well. So I'm going to go ahead, paste in the example API call, and then I'm going to say this is an example output. And then to get that, we're going to go back to OpenAI. Just click API reference on the top right. We'll go down to image right here. And then here, we could have also gotten the same example request here. But then here is the response, and this is what I want. So I'm going to copy that response. This is from the image. Also here you can see the other options you can do to change about and what you can do. So for example, here on background, on the GPT image 1 model, which is the one we're using, you can do transparent or opaque. By default it's going to be auto background, but you can customize a little bit more about this, which is pretty interesting. Some of them are only available on DALL-E 3, which is not what we're going to want to use, though. We're going to want to use the new image generation model. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and let's paste that in. And let's click Think so we can have a good PRD. And I'm going to send that away. And I'll pause the video while it's doing that. So we have our completed PRD here, which is what we're going to use to paste into Lovable. And we could use Bolt or Cursor, but in this case, I want to use Lovable. I think it's going to do a good job with this. So I'm going to go up to the right, copy the contents, and then let's go to Lovable. So here we are in the dashboard, and I'm just going to paste in that PRD. And I read it over, and I think it all looks pretty good, but feel free to make changes to yours if you need. And then let's go ahead and click Generate. And I'll pause the video while Lovable goes through all of the initial setup here. Okay, so we have our first landing page here, which I think looks pretty good. So it says it has simulated API integration, but we need to actually connect Supabase so that we can actually have the OpenAI API call happen. So the next thing I'm going to do before testing is I'm going to connect Supabase. So let's go ahead and do that. I will connect to a project or create a new project, whichever one you want to do. So I'm just going to go ahead and connect the project. If you created a new project, you do have to give it like a couple minutes to generate. So now it is connected, which is great. So let's go back to our project. If I scroll down, okay, it says the app is now connected. Great. So I'm going to say, let's now add the real API call from the PRD. Make sure it's set up correctly. Okay. So I'll pause the video while Lovable builds that out. Okay, so it says that it's set it up. What I want to do is also, so now I have to add my API key from OpenAI. So just click add API key. Get your API key from your dashboard in OpenAI under API keys on the bottom left. I'm going to paste mine in. So I'm going to pause the video while I do that. I'm also just asking it to set the API call for image generation quality parameter to medium because I don't want to spend too much money, and I think medium is a good, I tested low, medium, and high. I didn't see as big of a difference between medium and high as low to medium. Of course, for your use case, you're going to want to do some testing. Quality standard. Why standard? So that shouldn't, I'm going to say the quality should be medium, not standard. So hopefully that solves it, and I'll pause the video while it's doing that. And then I'm going to do one more thing just to test this because I can't, while I'm recording this video, activate my camera. So what I'm going to do is say, please also allow the user to upload an image if they don't want to activate their camera. Everything else can work the same. So let's let it build that out. So I tested it out and I clicked generate cartoon versions and it didn't work. So I'm just going to try to debug this, and I'm also going to give it the API documentation again. Sometimes this is helpful because it's possible that just not doing the API call correctly. So anytime you're working with an API call and it doesn't work, it's always good to give it that documentation again just to ensure that it's going to do it correctly. So let's try this again. I'm going to click generate cartoons. No cartoons can be generated. Okay. So I'm going to say, I got this error. Please debug and solve this. And then also, I'm in my Supabase account. If I go to Edge Functions, click into the Edge function that was created, which is the API call that we're doing, I can see the exact error message that happened, which is going to be really helpful. So let's pull this over so I can see. So there's some issue with the response. Okay. So I'm going to copy the event message, and then let's go back, and I'm going to say, this is the error message from Supabase, Edge function. So there's an error with the response format. I just gave it the response format, so hopefully it'll be okay now. So I'm going to send that, Let's pause while it fixes the issue. And just something to note is that giving it that specific error message always helps. So if you can go into Supabase and get that, it's always going to help. Be sure to stick with me because the final result, I'm really excited to share with you. And I'm just re-emphasizing what the API call should be because here, what it says is it is the API is expecting to return a URL to the generated image, which is not correct. It is going to receive a base64 image. I know this because this is what's in the documentation. So, yeah, hopefully this final result will resolve this. Okay, let's test it out. I uploaded a video, generate cartoon versions, and we got an error. Okay. So let's check our Supabase logs. Here's the error. And it looks like there's an error in the API call because it's happening so quickly. So I'm going to copy the message and I'm going to say, I got this error. I'm going to switch to chat mode and say, can you please give me the exact API call we are sending to OpenAI so I can review it? So this is a tip that I would definitely recommend you using in Lovable is use chat. This allows you to chat without making edits to the project, which I find helpful. So yeah, that's exactly what I was hoping it would see is that the response format here should not be included, which is exactly what the issue is. So it should be a pretty simple issue. I'm just going to say implement this plan. So this is something still one of something I don't like as much about Lovable. And Bolt for that matter, that I really like about using Cursor and Windsurf is that I can choose the model with Cursor and Windsurf. So, like with Cursor, if I was having this issue, I would just jump up to the 2.5 Pro Max model, which costs 5 cents to run per call, but it would have solved it immediately because it's just a more powerful model. Lovable hides all of that behind the scenes. So, I don't know what model it's using. It's clearly not listening fully. Lovable and Bolt, they're trying to balance making a product that is able to get you the result you want without using too powerful and too expensive models in the back end. So, just an example of something here, but it says it fixed it. So, let's try to refresh and let's try this one more time. And let's see if it actually works this time. Okay, already a good start. The fact that it's still loading is awesome. It worked. We actually got a response here. We got four versions of the cartoon version of me. Pretty cool, actually. I think it did a pretty good job. Some of them I think are a little better than others, but like for the first version of this app, I really like it. I want to make a change here. I'm going to ask it what styles of cartoon each of the four being generated, being told to be made. Because I just let it kind of come up with that on its own. And in the next version, I want to kind of modify these so it's a little bit more specific. So let's see. Oh, interesting. So somehow Lovable decided to put kind of like filters over it, but the initial generation sent to OpenAI is the same, which is not what I want. So great. So this is helpful to know. So let me write a prompt here. So I'm telling it to remove the CSS filters after the image is received, because I don't know, I didn't really want that. And now I'm going to say I want the cartoons to be different styles, generic, which is the same prompt, Ghibli or Ghibli, not sure how to say it, but that's kind of the viral style that's been going around Twitter, Disney style and Pixar style. And obviously, you could do as many styles as you want, but I'll do that. And I'm still using chat mode because I want to have it kind of come up with a plan first, and then I'll have it implement that plan. And now I'm going to implement the plan. So it says it applied those changes. Let's generate the version. And I'll pause the video while we generate. And here we go. It worked perfectly. We have our result. We have four different versions. I'm just making one more change to put the label over or below the image instead of overlaid because I want the user to be able to see the whole image and not be distracted by the overlay there. All right, cool. It made the change, and I like this where it has the little download button. I also asked for that, and it's not kind of interfering with actually seeing the image itself. So, what do you think? Should I turn this into a real app, add a paywall, maybe have people pay, $5 for 20 images, something like that? I could figure out the pricing, and kind of give more versions of each, let people choose the version. There's a lot more I could do, but let me know. Subscribe, and maybe I'll make a future video on actually monetizing this app. and we'll see how much money I could actually make from it. We also run No Code MBA, one of the largest and most popular no code and AI education platforms. And if you want to learn more about building with AI and no code tools from top experts, learning how to build fully functioning apps and websites from start to finish, click the link in the description. We're giving away $50 off on top of whatever other discount there might be on the site right now. So an additional $50 off of everything. Click the link in the description, and the first 25 people to claim that discount will get it. After that, the discount code will be gone. So click the link in the description if you want to check out No Code MBA. And also, if you have an app idea, but you don't have the time to build it yourself and don't want to learn on a platform like No Code MBA, click the link in the description to go to our AI developer match. We will match you with an expert AI developer who can take your app idea and turn it into a reality. Click the link in the description to learn more about that. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.